You might think I'm watching some TV series right now, or maybe I'm in the metaverse. But no, actually, I'm learning to fly my new first-person view micro drone. And this is my new video about my new hobby, which I've been spending several hours a day on lately. I've wanted to try FPV drone flying for a long time. YouTube often recommended short videos with masterful and exciting footage and flights. But I immediately realized that this level of skill takes years to develop. So I decided to start small with this micro drone from Beta FPV. You might ask why I chose this one specifically. The thing is, for a reasonable price of $250, I got a complete kit that met all my learning needs. It's a great option for those unsure if this hobby is for them, and if you don't want to invest a lot of money initially. Trust me, for beginners learning to fly a drone, this kit is the perfect solution. The set includes a controller, the drone itself, goggles, and a bunch of batteries with a charger. Considering that one battery lasts for 5 to 7 minutes of flight, having several spare batteries is a great idea. Everything comes in a cool protective fabric case that does not take up much space. Now, let's do some flying. This drone has three flight modes that can be switched using the SB switch. The first flight mode is N mode. It features altitude hold. Altitude hold allows the quadcopter to hover automatically. The quadcopter can stay at a set height even if I take my hands off the controller. This is because the quadcopter has a built-in laser that ensures precise and stable positioning. Thanks to this, even a beginner can start learning to fly the quadcopter indoors. The second flight mode is S mode. In this case, the quadcopter becomes more freely controlled, but still helps you automatically by leveling horizontally. The third mode is the most professional, M mode, also known as Acro mode. In this case, the drone is under your full control in all three axes of movement and rotation. This is the most professional mode and the one in which I am learning and training to control the drone. Before we continue, please like and subscribe to the channel. Also, you can click the bell icon to not miss new videos. By the way, you can support me and become my sponsor on YouTube or Patreon. This is a unique opportunity to become part of our private community and get access to exclusive content. I constantly share mockups, interesting fonts, wallpapers, and other useful design materials with my sponsors. Thank you for your support. Let's continue. The only downside to this drone is the inability to record your flight videos. Yes, you can only observe in real time through the goggles, but unfortunately, you can't record the flight. To do this, you need to buy an additional transmitter that can record your flight on the same frequency as the goggles. For initial training, I recommend flying without goggles, at all because you need to learn how to maintain altitude first. The second stage is flying forward and backward. At this point, I advise moving alone with the drone. But flying the drone in FPV often does not work out, so flying simulators come in handy. The most popular one is Liftoff. This simulator supports the controller via a USB Type-C cable. In this case, I am using the charging cable from my iPhone. And this is how I sit and train for 1 to 2 hours a day. Learning to fly is very challenging. I constantly have to take off and start over. Then I crash again and start over. But during those moments, when I manage to fly well, I get immense pleasure. By the way, this type of flying, although it gives an idea of control, is still significantly different from controlling a real drone. Therefore, I periodically combine simulator flights with the actual drone flights. My goal is to learn to fly the drone around the apartment without hitting anything. I wonder how long it will take. The good thing about this drone is that for training, you don't even need to get up from your chair until you crash into something and fall. And you can use anything as an obstacle, a chair, a tripod, or even your legs. This drone is so small and light that it's unlikely to cause any damage to itself or surrounding objects. So learning with it is pure joy. If you're interested in following my progress, be sure to subscribe to my social media through the links in the description box and to my YouTube channel. I hope this video was interesting and useful for you. By the way, you can also find the link to buy this drone in the description box. Thank you for watching. See you soon and happy flying!